Jurassic Park about to come true? Are we about to resurrect dinosaurs? Hello and welcome back to Inform Overload. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and today we're talking about some eerily similar circumstances. Now, these are taking place in real life and they strongly reflect what happened in Jurassic Park. Before we get stuck into this video, I just want to remind all of you to leave our video with a thumbs up, and of course, please do leave us a comment with your thoughts on dinosaurs at the end. Also, if you like this video, I've got a strong feeling that you will love our new channel, Life's Biggest Questions. It deals with all kinds of historical debates, as well as political questions and the odd trending question. I'm gonna leave a link to that in the description box down below. You know how the whole plot of Jurassic Park pretty much centers on the discovery of a mosquito trapped in amber with dinosaur blood in its system. Then the scientists extract the mosquito and clone the dinosaur, right? Right. Well, in eerily similar circumstances, scientists have found a 100 million year old piece of amber with a tick in it. Guess what that tick's last meal was? Dinosaur. This tick is being dubbed the Dracula tick, and it had bloated up to 8 times its usual size as it filled up on dinosaur blood. Inside another piece of ancient Burmese amber, another tick was found still holding onto a dinosaur feather from 99 million years ago. While in the movies, scientists are able to successfully extract the blood from the mosquito to recreate the dinosaurs, in real life, scientists are struggling to remove any complete DNA from the blood. This is because the molecules have deteriorated over time, which is understandable considering the blood is 100 million years old. 100 million! Can you guys even imagine what the Earth looked like 100 million years ago? Like, humans have only been around for 200,000 years, so 100 million. Oh my goodness. What is crazy too is that the tick found in the amber actually looks pretty similar to what we know of ticks today. It's totally insane to me to think that ticks have survived in some way or another all this time. The oldest pieces of amber that we know of are around 300,000 years old, so who knows what we may find fossilized in the future. Perhaps the next parasitic creature we free from amber will have less deteriorated blood in it. Now, this might mean that we're able to get a better DNA match for dinosaurs. Seeing their fossils is one thing, but imagine a world where a real life Jurassic Park existed and you could walk amongst the dinosaurs. Would that be awesome or would it be scary? Would we be playing God if we made that kind of thing happen? Is it even ethical? What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments section down below. So that is all I have on this story for you. Before I go, I just want to read a few comments about my video yesterday, which was all about NASA making a huge announcement today. Ready to Watch said, "I've always wanted to go to space, but now I want to go to space even more." I agree, but which would you rather though, dinosaurs on Earth or space travel? I think I'd go space travel, actually. Absent-minded Prof said, "If aliens see you, Rebecca, they will definitely come here." Then they put a thumbs up, a smile, and then a beer emoji. And I feel like the succession of these three emojis is like an accurate representation of what I have to offer aliens. Beer. Share a beer with an alien. Do you think they'd like beer? Do aliens like beer? Denise Thompson said, "Rebecca, aliens are all around us. Love your song." Thank you, my alien song is one of my finest. Aliens are all around us, but actually, I thought that Christmas was all around us. I need to start binge watching Love Actually before Christmas. It's firmly on the agenda. Thank you guys for watching. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. So it is my last day in the studio before Christmas and New Year. Luckily, Charlotte will be back with you tomorrow and will be with you up until Christmas. If you guys want to see more of me, you can check me out on social media. Links are in the description box down below. And of course, you can catch me regularly on Life's Biggest Questions and Most Amazing Top 10 and my own channel where I'm making Harry Potter videos every day up until Christmas. Maybe next year I'll make Jurassic Park videos. Dinosaurs are cool. Dinosaurs are really cool. Also, one final shout out to my friend Jack Ewens, who worked on the last Jurassic Park movie and is working on the new one too. You should go follow him on Twitter because he's cool, like dinosaurs. Okay, that's a lot of information. If you like this video, make sure you give it a good thumbs up, share it with a friend, and stay subscribed to IO. If you want to continue watching IO, check out our videos on the Dear David ghost and the original NASA announcement video. See you next time.